Hello students, we'll move on with the next topic, that is form handling. The most powerful feature of PHP is the way in which it handles HTML forms. So forms you can say is the most common way for a user to communicate information from a web browser to the server. XHTML provides tags to generate the commonly used objects on a screen form. These objects are also called as controls or widgets. So you might have already used some of the controls like text boxes, radio buttons. So whatever data you're entering in this control or widgets, these data are called as form data. Okay. So whenever you hit the submit button, so whatever data you have entered, or you can also call it as form data, that is encoded and sent to the web server for processing. Okay. So all components of a form appear within the tag, that is a form tag. Okay, so any form element is available to a PHP script via the name attribute. So you have the attribute called as name. So using this attribute, form element will be made available to the PHP script. Basic requirement to connect HTML form to the PHP scripts are form properties such as method and action. So you have some properties like method and action. So those are required to connect your HTML form to the PHP scripts. We are going to see about this in the next slide. Along with that, you have the name property of input types. That's what we said here, name attribute. And the form submit button that is used to submit the request to the server when the PHP script, where the PHP script resides. Okay. So we will see the syntax. Okay. So all these components can be placed inside the form tag. So we'll see the syntax of the form tag here. So you're writing form, and after that we have action. So action is going to tell us where you have to submit this data. Okay, so is the page the form should submit its data to, or it can be the URL where you have to submit the data that is filled in your form. And method can be either get or post. You have two methods, that is either get or post. So both get as well as post, what do they do is they just send the data to the server. Okay, so what is the difference between two, we will see in the next slide. For time being, action is going to tell you the location where you have to send your data, that is a form data. And method is going to, method that can be either get or post, what it is going to tell do, it is going to send your data. Okay. And after that, you can have any contents, like if you're using text boxes, then you're writing input type, then you are also giving name to that. And if you want to specify some size, you can put the size like this. You can have any of those widgets like radio buttons or text boxes, check boxes, all those things comes under your form content. And finally, you're going to close your form tag. Okay, so that is about the syntax of the form tag here. Next, we'll go to the method. So I said method can be either get or post. So we'll just see the difference between the get method as well as the post method. Okay. So get has restriction to send to server or database parts up to 1024 characters only. So in get, you have some restriction on the amount of size or amount of data what you can send to the server or to the database. So what is that restriction? That is 1024 characters only. Okay, so whenever you have any sensitive information, in such cases you should not use get method. Okay, so never use get method for system which has password or other sensitive information to be sent to the server. Okay, so that is the next point about your get. Get cannot be used to send binary data like images, Word documents to the server. So whatever data you are entering in the whatever data you are sending when you are using the get method, that data will be visible in the URL. Okay, so suppose here you have the browser. So here in the if you are using the get method, suppose you have asked for enter the username, so that information will be visible in the URL. That is if you're using the get method. So for that purpose, never use this get method whenever you're having any sensitive information. PHP provides this variable get associative array to access all the information sent by the get method. Okay, so this is used to collect all the information that is sent by the get method. So the main thing what you have to remember in get method is get method is used to send the information from the form to the server or to the database. But the main thing is you should not use this whenever you have some sensitive information, because whatever data you have entered, that will be visible in the URL. Okay, similarly next one you have the post method. So post method does not have that restriction what you have used in get. So in get we said that you have some limit on the amount of size of information what you can send to the server, but here post does not have any restriction on data size to be sent. Okay, and in this case it transfers the information via the HTTP's header. So for that purpose this is secure compared to your get method. Okay, it is relatively secure and can be used in large data requesting as well as responding. Post method can be used to send ASCII as well as binary data, which was not there in the get. Data transfer is secured enough on HTTP protocol since it goes through HTTP headers. So since the data what you are sending is going through HTTP headers, for that purpose the data sent through post method is secure. Okay, PHP provides this post associative array to access all the information sent by the post method. So there it was get, here it is post. Okay, you have one program that is given to you in your textbook, we'll just see that program. So you have so in your textbook they have given you, so you are entering the information, I'll just open it. Okay, so this is your popcorn3.html form where you are entering the information. So you can see here form action, so where the data should go, whatever data you have entered in this HTML form, where it should go. So where it should be sent, it should be sent to form.php, and the method you have used is post. So for that purpose it is secured. Okay, so method what does it do, it is going to send, and action is going to tell you where you have to send. So we have a heading called as welcome to ABC, then you are using a table. In the table you have buyer name, street address. So you can see here buyer name, and after that you have used, or you want a text box to be appearing there. Okay, and name, you have named it as name, and size you have given as 30. So that is just representing the length of your text box. Okay, similarly next one is to enter the street address, you have next text box to enter the street address, next text box to enter the city, state and zip code. Okay, then you have a table wherein the heading is product, price and quantity, and under this, so I'll just show you how this appears. So I'll just execute this. So we'll see. So here you can see welcome to ABC Club Popcorn Sales. Okay, so that is the heading what we had given here, welcome to ABC. Then you have buyer name. So buyer name followed by a text box. So for that purpose how we have written, input type text, and you're given a name, that is a name attribute here, and the size. Okay, then next you have street address, next you have street address, next you have zip. Okay, so for that purpose you have the text box here for buyer name, street address as well as city. Next you have a table, you have mentioned the table border here, then under the table you have the heading as product, price and quantity. Okay, so you have the heading as product, price and quantity. Then you have unpopped popcorn, unpopped popcorn as the first row entry there, and what is the price of that. So price of that, so product name is unpopped popcorn, price is $3, and you have to enter the quantity. So the quantity has to be entered by you. So for that purpose we have used a text box here, and the name attribute of that text box you're given as unpop. Similarly next is for, next product is caramel popcorn, price is $3.50. next is caramel nut popcorn price, and next you have toffee nut popcorn, price as $5. Okay, So that is what you can see here, unpopped caramel, caramel nut as well as toffee nut. And the price is mentioned here. Quantity you have to enter. Okay, so I'll give the name here. Quantity I will give. I'll be entering the quantity. Okay, then next what you have the payment option. So for the payment option, you have the heading here, payment method. Then you have used. So here you have used the widget, that is radio button. Okay, so here the widget what you had used was text box. Now we are going for the radio button. So the type is radio, name is payment, and value here you have given as Visa. One is MasterCard, one is Discover, and one is check. Okay, so you can see here, yes, you have the radio button with values Visa, MasterCard, Discovery, as well as check. Okay, so you can see here. Then after that, you have the submit button. So submit button, what does it do? Whatever data you have entered, that needs to be sent to the server. Okay, so for that purpose, you require the submit button, value is submit order. Then you also have the reset button, that is used to clear the entered data. Okay, finally you're closing. Okay, you're closing your HTML. Okay, next, so this is your form.html. So we will I will select, then I'll give submit. So when I have given submit, so you can see here, whatever data I have entered, what is the action that should go to form.php. So you can see here in form.php, what do you have? So you see here, this is my form.php. So whatever data I have entered is been sent to form.php. Okay, so in form.php you have the customer name. Before that, what and all we will see. Before that, the title you have as process. Then, so you have entered there unpop. What value you have entered, that is stored in this variable. Similarly for caramel, what value you have entered. So all this data is stored, name, street, city, payment, all this data is stored. Then here what you're doing here is, if any of those text boxes or entries you have given blank, in that case it is set to a value 0. Okay, and in the next part, what you're doing, you're computing or you're calculating. So we had given quantity there, right? So unpop popcorn unit price. So unit price is 3. I have ordered quantity 2. So 3 into 2, that is 6. So that is what you're doing here. 3 into 2. And again, next is 3.5 into how many quantity I have stored. So all these are for the calculation purpose. So this part, what does it do? It is performing the calculation. Finally, you have to calculate the total price. Total price is add all this. Okay, add all this, then total items. You're adding all the items. Okay, so here you're adding the cost, here you're adding the items. So this is a heading, that is customer. So you can see here, customer followed by the name of the customer will be appearing, that is name, street, and city, whatever you had entered in popcorn. That is, in my case, I have named as form.html. Whatever I have entered there in that HTML form, that is retrieved. Okay, and here you can see the next part. Yes, so it is displayed in the form of table. So order information, the headings are table heading are product, unit price, quantity order, item cost. Alignment you have made center, so that is for this. Okay, center alignment. So you have unpop popcorn with unit price 3, quantity 2, and the cost. So like this for all the items you are printing. Okay, so this is just a formatting what you have done. Then for all the items it is printed. Then finally your total ordered item. So how many items you have ordered, the total of that, and what is the total amount. Okay, then you have chosen method, that is what payment option you have selected. So total ordered item is 82468, and total bill is sum of all this, and the method I've chosen is discover. So this is the example program that is given to you in your textbook for form handling. In case they'll ask you in the exam, just shorten, you can shorten this and write. Okay, thank you.